A common design practice in version in Alpha 5 grids is to filter the grid based on the value of an argument. And a common design pattern might be to try to print out the value of that argument, say, in a freeform region that you place above or below the grid. So in this example over here, you can see that we have a freeform region above the grid, and the grid is being filtered. So if we go back to design mode and we go over to define arguments, we can see that this grid uses two arguments, one called ST and one called LN. And in both cases, the arguments are bound not to session variables, but to page variables. If the arguments had been bound to session variables, then the techniques that are shown here could still be used, but would not be necessary because you could just refer to the session variable value directly. But because they are bound to page variables, the problem becomes a little bit more difficult. So what we have here is a grid that is filtered on two arguments, and then if we go to the above grid, we can see here that what we have is some text, and then inside the text we have a span, and where we would like to put the value of the state argument, and the span has an ID of state name, all in lowercase. So now what I'm going to do is go over to this to fields, and you can see here that we have a button, and in the button I'm calling a method of the grid called argument value. This is a new method that has recently been added, and I can get to see the method by just going over here and then typing in argumentva. So there's the argument value, and basically this method just takes the name of the argument that you want to retrieve. So in this case here, I'm just getting it into a JavaScript variable called x, and then I'm alerting it, and then I'm setting the inner HTML of that span, which had an ID of state name, to x. So ultimately I'm going to copy this code to the clipboard and put it into a client-side event, but I first want to demonstrate it in use over here. So let's go now over to working preview, and now when I press this button, you can see the JavaScript fires. It goes and retrieves the value of the argument. There it is, MA, and then it sets the value of the span over there. So now let's go and remove this code from the button, and then go over now to a client-side event, and what I'm going to do is go to the after grid render event. I'll go to the on render complete event, and then I'll paste it in over there, and then I'll just remove the alert, and let's go save it away, and then run the grid, and you can see there we have the value of the argument. So this video shows how you can use a method of the grid object to retrieve the value of any argument that was passed into the grid, and which has been used in the grid filter. Thank you very much.